This year has been unique with 11 seniors. I've never had this many. And not only do I have 11 seniors, but they're all pretty good basketball players. And with that, we only have 3 juniors in our program. We have some pretty good juniors that did not get some playing time based on the quality play that we got from our seniors. With that, it's nice to deal with 17 and 18 year old kids that have been through the program and know what it's all about. So for me, it was just a matter of watching them grow for 4 years and putting the product out. And it's been a fantastic product with 17 regular season wins.
Great coach. I love his style because he's really old. Well, I wouldn't say really old, but I mean, he's aging. And I just like his style. He always brings us, you know, joy every single time he comes to practice. He usually runs our Saturday morning practices and stresses about how we're supposed to be a team. And
we have Coach Amon. He's a good inspirational leader, pretty fiery guy.
Coach Amon is a really personal guy. He's a lot of fun, but he also can be very serious, which makes him a great coach and a good friend.
Go!
shot.
Basketball here at CAA has taught me a lot about responsibility, and it's given me a lot more confidence as well. Responsibility in that, like, you have to keep up with schoolwork and play basketball. You have to show up to basketball on time. You have to do certain amounts of drills. And then with the confidence, the more I've played here, the more I've gotten confidence from the coaches and how they've taught me throughout the years, and confidence in life.
Being a beacon through our career, it's mostly just, like, it's not about you. It's about, you know, what's better for the team, what you can do to help the team, and just, you know, playing your role and stuff like that. Yeah, and just letting your light shine.
We'll be right back.
favorite basketball moment would probably be from the beginning of the year when we played Crystal Ray. It was a really close game to start out with, and to start the season to come back and win that game, it was a great start to our season.
Throughout the season, there was a great moment where Sam face planted out in St. Cloud. That was pretty awkward because it's Sam.
So. Favorite basketball game, I'd say, the first game at St. Cloud against Watertown Mayor, where it was a tough game, but we ended up winning in a close one at the end.
I didn't know what to expect because I hadn't gone up there last year, but it was really fun. I got to bond a lot with my roommates and teammates, and it was a really good experience.
He always does a lot of work for us, goes out and watches games, no matter how far away they are. He does a good job of that for us.
Harstead does a lot of all the scouting, really. He's great. He's got so much information on every team for us, and we all love him.
Baseline drive and you have 35, you gotta see where he's at.
And it's coming off their Butler call. So they call Butler, they go run Michigan action on the wing. That guy, the guard, comes off hard, he's curling. He starts moving to the basket, and what happens is he's looking to dish 35 coming down.
I learned to be more disciplined and to think of my teammates first before myself.
That hard work pays off, and that teamwork is the best way to win.
It's a time where I have to dedicate myself to it. It's not like I'm just playing a sport. I actually have to work hard at it and to get minutes and push myself.
Never give up. You know, sometimes we have bad days and we just gotta keep looking up. Can't put our heads down. We gotta keep pushing forward, so.
special delivery, homie. Welcome to my world. Life's a tour, I'm so sure. The egg's so pure before you exit Europe. No more games, I confess. Far from lame, just so fresh. Who would leave? It's the big boss. New kid on the block, Mr. Rudolph. Two stars, hold your applause. I hold it down, yours all guitars. Half my life I sacrificed. But I only came
to... Chuddy and Coach Chuddy always has your back in a game, I know. I have a lot of problem with complaining towards refs, but I don't have to because I know I can shut my mouth and he'll do all the complaining to the refs for me. And
Eric Chuddy, he's a really good coach, really pushes us. Definitely when it comes to game, he's always focused and he helps us get focused before games. And I really think that's a good characteristic of a coach.
You can tell he puts in his time for his team. He watches video and he knows his stuff and he coaches as well. So,
Coach Chuddy. He's a good coach.
I think the funniest moment of the season is when we played Columbia Heights and Ben Vallon was guarding this guy at half court and Coach Chuddy was yelling at him to get back. And he was yelling at him for like 5 seconds and he didn't hear it. It was really funny. So that's probably the funniest moment of the season.
probably beating St. Anthony at their place. We hadn't won there in a long time, and so it was really cool to go in there and beat them, so it was really cool.
St. Anthony and Isaiah Maddox didn't play the whole first half, but then in the second half he came out and scored 21 points, and we won the game. That was awesome.
I've learned to be patient and just enjoy it. You know, it goes by super fast. I mean, it just seems like a month ago I was a freshman and now I'm a senior and this is the last time I'll be here. So just being patient and being joyful and then just enjoying the moment. Yeah. It's definitely made me a better person on and off the court. So.
For the basketball program, I learned that you really just gotta push yourself and you can grow in any aspect.
Work ethic can make practices and games fun. And just like playing with your teammates is a good bonding experience to get to know people.
What up?
Roger Moore Jr. Is a three-year starter for us. You know, he's a treat to have on the team. He makes me look good. He does things that I haven't seen before in terms of passes. You got to be ready, or he'll hit you in the face if you don't. If you're not ready to catch a pass, he'll leave here in the 1,000-point club, breaking a ton of records, assist records for season, free throws made. It's been nice to see him grow and progress in the 4 years that he's been here, and it's so nice to have a point guard as your leader on the court, who is an extension of yourself. Roger also becomes the second player ever to play in the Minnesota State High School League All-Star game, and that's a privilege to play in that. He'll go on in college and do well. Isaiah Maddox transferred in here for the first year, and what a great fit for us. Got a chance to play at the varsity level this year, became a threat inside and out for us, was a great defender, fit in well with the guys. It's not easy when you transfer in and trying to fit in with a group. We have such great guys here that they accepted him. He accepted us. He became a part of our program, part of our culture that we have made in the last 12 years here. And great addition to us and a big part of why we got the wins this year like we did. And Isaiah will go on and play college basketball some year, someday, and be very, very successful. Sam Root, one of the best posts I've ever had here. I nicknamed him a little bit at the end of the season, the Warrior, because he's constantly on the floor. I don't know how many double-doubles he had this year, probably two or three. Became an outstanding finisher underneath the hoop. You know, about 65% or higher shooting percentage. And he never took a playoff in practice or in a game. You're gonna miss that sort of leadership presence. He also is a three-sport athlete, playing football and also playing baseball. Sam will be missing this program. We've had a long line of good posts, and he becomes one of the best ones we've ever had. Jacob Falk has worked his tail off to get to where he was this year. Very detail-oriented. Is a starter on most teams. He was the best sixth man in the league, and he came off the bench for every game and was a spark for us. Added some extra size. We were able to put him in with Sam at the same time, and if one of them got into foul trouble, then Jacob would fill in that role. Extended his range, shooting range from inside to about 10 feet. So detail-oriented that his game progressed, and he does the same way in the classroom, and he's going to be successful on and off the court next year. Mark Stage is a latecomer last year, his junior year. Started to play halfway through the year after starting on the junior varsity. Became our sharpshooter from the outside. His work ethic led to his success of getting on the court and starting every game this year. You know, Mark is very detail-oriented also. There isn't a lot of joking around with him. He's pretty serious, and kind of my mentality also. So him and I had some good conversations this year on what needed to be done and how we could get better. His leadership will be missed. Connor Johnson has started a ton of games from his junior to senior year. Became really good defensively his junior year. Became an outstanding shooter his senior year, and he's a product of the system. He also put in a lot of time. Connor is gonna be missed because he does a lot of little things, getting on the floor. A lot of times he had to defend the best player on the other team, and you know, he never complained once about anything. Never took a playoff in practice or a game, and really progressed into a strong young man, which will carry him on into the future. Ben Vallon was rewarded this year with some varsity time after playing junior varsity for 3 years. Strong player. I'm so proud of Ben to work as hard as he did in order to earn his minutes. He became a guy that was physical inside. When he got his plays in the game, he was in almost every play, diving on the floor, taking a charge. He wasn't afraid to take the ball to the glass. And that competitive nature and self-confidence led to his success, which really gave us some depth. Ben will be very successful because he works so hard on and off the field and or the court, and he'll be very successful in college. Cole Lysakal plays three sports here, football, basketball, baseball. I've known Cole for a long time, since he's been little. He lives up the street from me, and he has been playing on the varsity since his junior year. Really improved this year with his outside shot, his defense, and earned his time by working hard. You know, he had some ups and downs, but the good thing about Cole is he fought through those downs and certainly got back up on those at the end of the year and really made the best of his senior year. Mike Nordby, so glad he came out to play this year, took his junior year off, made the best decision in his life of high school to come and play this year, knowing that he's going to have to work hard. Mike was a great scout player, and when he got his minutes, he made the most of it. The guys cheered every time he got the ball to try to make it, and he missed some easy ones, but also connected a few times underneath the hoop. I've known Mike for 4 years, and he took that junior year off, and I saw this big size and body, and I kind of missed him, and then all of a sudden this year had a change of heart, and he still had to make the team in November, which he did, and that'll pay off for him going through a basketball season at Concordia. Cole Schuessler, three-sport athlete, soccer, baseball, basketball. Another player as a senior, did not get a lot of minutes, but you would never know it how he practiced. He loved practicing. He never took a playoff in practice. When he got his minutes in the game, he made the most of them. That mentality and that work ethic goes so far in life, farther than just a simple basketball game or basketball practice, and that drive to be successful will be with him in everything he does. Sean Cardinal. Sean also worked so hard like most of those other guys who didn't get a lot of minutes. It's not easy to practice and play so much and then not play so much in a game, and you'd never know it with Sean because he played hard in everything he did. When he got his minutes, he made the most of them. Sean has been with us for 4 years. And he had to make the team this November, and I know he was a little nervous about that, but you know, his work ethic kicked in, and his character also played in a big part of being a part of Concordia basketball, and he'll be successful as he moves on into the future.